Hi all, today we are going to discuss about Ampere's circuital law. So Ampere's circuital law states that the line integral of h around a closed path is equal to the current enclosed by the path. So what is the meaning of this? So this can be represented as closed line integral of, if you are taking the closed line integral of h dot dl, this will be nothing but the current enclosed by the particular path. So this is the statement of Ampere circuital law. So let us take it as equation number 1. The meaning is, for example, let us assume the current is passing through some particular conductor. So let us assume I am taking a closed path. In this closed path, if you take the closed line integral of this one, this closed line integral of whatever the h that is passing in this line, this will be nothing but equal to the current that is enclosed within this. Let us assume this I is equal to this current enclosed. Whatever is coming, that will come here. So this I can find by applying Stokes' theorem to the left hand side. So here I am writing on a glass screen, so the handwriting doesn't come properly. I am providing the complete handwritten material in the link in the description below. It is Google Drive link is provided there. You can download the complete material from there. Here you just try to understand what is the concept I am teaching. Remaining material for the exam you can please download from there. Here you try to understand what I am teaching only. So I can tell that this closed integration of h dot dl, this is the line integration. So we have already seen that in our last class that this will be equal to, as per Stokes theorem, this will be curl of h ds. This is what we have seen. Let us take it as equation number 2. And we know that the current enclosed, or the current, can be written as, so let me try to erase this. So I can write the current enclosed, because current is nothing but surface integral of j dot ds. This also we have seen before while discussing about the current. So combining this equation number 2 and 3, because both are having the surface integral, so I can tell that the curl h is equal to j. We can write that curl h is equal to j. This is what we get. So this is called as nothing but the Ampere's law in the differential form. This is Ampere's law in differential form. So because this is in the differential form, and this will be Ampere's law in integral form. This is also called as the Maxwell's third equation in electrostatics. So that we are going to see later on. Let us now see what are the applications of this Ampere circuital law. So I am discussing about the applications. So today we will complete about the line integral and the surface integral and infinitely long coaxial transmission line we will see in the next class. So first I am starting with infinite line current. I am taking an infinite line current. So in that case, how to do? Let us assume a line current is lying along the z axis. Let us assume this is my z axis, and we can tell the remaining axis. This is my y axis and this is my x axis. Let us assume the current is lying up to the infinite length. So it is along this z axis. Along the z axis the current is existing. So let us assume the current is given by I. So now if you want to calculate this, we will take one Amperean line. The line is called as Amperean line. So the line or the path should be taken in such a way that whatever the value of h that comes, because in this path, so either that will be in the same direction or it should be equal to 0, so that I can directly calculate the value just by multiplying the length we are traversing. So like for example, in the case of the line charge, we know that as per the right hand rule, if your thumb is indicating the direction of a current, then your curled fingers will indicate the direction of the flux or the direction of the magnetic field. So from that I can calculate that this is my value of the dl. So this path, because it is in the same path in which the h passes, this is called as, so Amperean path. So this is called as Amperean path. It is similar to that of Gaussian surface we have discussed before. Let us try to apply here. So I can tell that the current that is passing will be closed line integral of, this h is moving in the direction of that path we are taking in the phi direction. So h in the direction of a phi, this, know that h will be in this direction, multiplied by the path we are taking. That path we are taking will be, that dl will be rho d phi in the direction of a phi. Only that particular direction component will be there, remaining component will cancel out. That's why directly I am only taking that path, so that I can directly multiply it. That is the main reason I am doing this. So this I can write as h phi into closed line integral of rho d phi. This is what I can write. So this I can write as h phi into the integration of rho d phi will be rho. This will be rho multiplied by, we are making an angle of 2 phi. So this will be 2 phi. Or from this, I can calculate my value of h. The h in the phi direction, or h will be equal to, from this equation, I divided by 2 pi rho in the direction of a phi. So in this way, I can calculate the magnetic field due to infinite line charge, I by 2 pi rho in the direction of a phi. I hope it is clear up to here. Let us see how to calculate for the case of infinite sheet of current. So I am taking infinite sheet of current. For calculating this infinite sheet of current, let us take the coordinates as, these are the three coordinates. So this is my x, this is my value is y, this is my z coordinate. Let us assume whatever my components are there, those components, that infinite sheet of current is lying along the x-axis. Let us assume it is lying along the x-axis like this. It is extending up to infinite. So let us assume this charge density that is coming, k is equal to some k naught in the direction of ax. This is the value. So for calculating the value, so what I am doing, I am taking the Amperian loop as like this. This is my Amperian loop. And I told you, whenever you are taking the loop, you have to take like that. Always you should travel in such a way that always your area will be in the left hand side. So I am traveling in this direction, so that always my area will be in the left hand side. So let us take the numbering of this as, I am moving from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4. So let us see what are the symmetry, so that I need not waste my time in calculating all the components. So for knowing the symmetry, let us assume I am taking one component of the current sheet at this point, because current is coming in positive x direction, I am taking it as dot. Similarly, another point here. Getting it? So let us take this as point number 1, let us take this as point number 2. So let us take, for example, I am taking some current charge. So the current, the flux will encircle that one, the magnetic field. So how it will encircle? You have to take the thumb, because current is coming out, thumb is pointing towards us. So encircling fingers will come like this. That means in this direction they will encircle. So if you are taking any point here, this will be analyzed like this. So if you are taking any point here, it will come like this. Similarly, any point here, it will be encircled like this, or any point here, it will encircle like that. So now let us try to calculate what is the magnetic field due to this one at some particular point here and a similar particular point here. So at this particular point, if you are trying to take a circle, because the circle will come, because here the radius will be maximum below this one. So we can tell that the circle will go like this. If you take the tangent, so the dh will come because of this one like this. This is dh due to the first one. Similarly, the circle will extend and it will go become maximum again here, because the radius will be maximum here. So we can tell the h due to this one will be like this one. This is dh1 in the upper point, or the point where you are taking in the upper side. Okay, everyone agree with me? Similarly, because of the second one, again the radius will be maximum here. At this point, the radius will be less. So this will be the direction of dh due to the second one. Similar way, if you are taking here, here the radius will be maximum here, because the circle will go like this. This is the circle that is formed due to this one. So this is the one I think you will be able to visualize now. Okay, so here what is the value of the dh? So dh, because of the second one, will be like this. This is due to the dh2. So now this dh2 can be resolved into two components, one component along z direction and another component along x direction, or otherwise the resultant value of the magnetic field will be only in the direction of y here. This is my resultant value. So similar is the case here, the resultant value, because of these two, that will be aligned in the direction of y direction only. This is dh, because this is my y axis and this is my z axis. This is my z axis. So only y component is present and the z component is cancelling out. This is the first one. And the second observation, we will see that the upper point, if you are taking any point, the value in the lower side, at the symmetrical point in the lower side, will have the same magnitude. That means this magnitude will be equal to this magnitude. That means whatever the value I calculate here, same value will repeat here. And the second one, we have seen that if in the upper side, if dh is passing from right to left, in the lower side the same dh will pass from left to right. That means both the sides, the value of the h is in opposite directions. This is what we observe. Let us try to summarize what we have observed till now. So, after that we will proceed for the remaining things. So, since the current is in the AX direction, the X component of H will be absent. Because of the symmetrical distribution of the current with respect to the point at which the H is desired, the Z component of H will get cancelled out and only the Y component will be present. This is what we have observed from there. And the H above the plane at a point will be equal and opposite at a symmetrical point located below the plane. It will be same because it will cancel out. So, from this we can conclude that we have to calculate only the Y component, or we can tell that this closed integration of H dot dl, if you want to write, this will be nothing but the current enclosed by the closed path. So, that closed path we have to take 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 to 1 like this. So, only two components will be there, only the Y component will be there, Z component, that means 2 to 3 and 4 to 1 both will cancel out, only two components will be there. So, those I am directly writing. If you are moving from 1 to 2, you are moving in the negative Y direction. So, this will become, let us assume this component is HY and you are moving from 1 to 2 in the direction of delta Y. Similarly, this will be HY, you are moving from 3 to 4 in the direction of positive delta Y we are moving. The first one we are moving in the negative delta Y direction. So, this will be equal to, the charge density is K naught. The charge density will be K naught in the direction of delta Y. This is what we get. So, now this I can write as minus HY from 1 to 2 into delta Y. So, we know because of the symmetry the second component will be same, but they are in opposite direction. So, HY of 3 to 4 into delta Y I can write as HY of 1 to 2 in the direction of delta Y. So, this I can write as K naught into delta Y. So, delta Y will cancel. So, I can write it as HY from 1 to 2 will be equal to minus K naught divided by 2, or from this I can calculate my value of H is equal to minus K naught divided by 2 in the direction of AY. Okay, as this minus AY I can represent as AX cross product with AZ, because AX cross AY is AZ, or if you are taking AX cross AZ, that will become minus AY. So, this is known. So, we can write the value of H, I can simply represent by the value of K cross AN divided by 2. This is the value of H, final answer we are getting for this surface charge case. I hope how to calculate the field intensity using the Ampere circuit law for the case of infinite line charge and infinite sheet of current is completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.